chubby D. We just
hello. That song, I Just Called to Say I Love You, has been Stevie Wonder's biggest hit so far. It won him an Oscar and reached number one in every country it was released in. Typically for an artist who's long been actively involved in human rights, he dedicated it to Nelson Mandela. For almost three decades, Stevie Wonder's been producing hits. His songs continue to be covered by other artists, and the trademark Stevie Wonder sound is currently proving a source of inspiration for young bands. We visited Stevie Wonder at his Wonderland Studios in Los Angeles, where he was at work on his new album, Conversation Piece, P-E-A-C-E. In Kaz Gorham's film, we talked to him about the album, about the still-troubled city of Los Angeles, and a career that began many songs ago in Hitsville, Motown Records, a small studio in Detroit, when Stevie Wonder was little Stevie Wonder.
Now, children of the surf, do you think there are seven wonders of the world? Well, here's the eighth, Little Stevie Wonder.
Everybody come on, yeah, yeah. Clap your hands. Yeah. Everybody come on, yeah, 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 yeah. Clap your hands, yeah. Come on, clap your hands. Don't you see? Get with the rhythm of the that's my dream happy dream.
Stevie Wonder writes his songs on a braille keyboard that records his lyrics phonetically.
met Stevie Wonder in this very room. I was standing here speaking with Berry Gordy, who was working on the controls. Stevie Wonder and one of the Miracles' little brothers walked into the building and walked right past this control room on down into the recording studio, which you can see out of the picture window. She was about 10 and a half years old at the time when started playing the piano. Then he started hitting on the drums, and he was just shaking his head and having a good time. Berry Gordy looked up from what he was doing, and he watched this kid
He had great rhythm, great attitude. I could see he was blind. He was just moving his head, and he was playing and going and doing everything, and it was great, you know. But I was wondering, what's the big deal? Because I wasn't in the market for a drummer. But then he left the drums, and he started playing the bongos, and he did that, and it was okay, it was nice. And then he, of course, sung. He, you know, I wasn't thrilled with his voice particularly, but it was okay, it was good. And then he went to the harmonica. Now that impressed me.
Young Steve Lynde Morris signed a contract with an even younger Motown and was given a new name.
The name Stevie Wonder came about because people were saying, here's a guy playing the drums, the bongos, the harmonica, and all the stuff, and he was a little wonder. And people were calling him a little wonder, and the name just stuck.
Little Stevie Wonder soon became part of the small Motown family that included Mary Wells, Martha Reeves and the Vandellas, the Miracles, the Supremes and the Marvelettes.
So I would hear various people working on stuff. I remember hearing the Temptations singing My Girl and Jerry Lewis, hearing the strings being put on it. I was able to listen and enjoy it as a 14-year-old kid. I was listening to things that were coming out.
Detroit in the early 60s was a town dominated by the automobile industry, which provided jobs for the city's large black community. Berry Gordy, a former boxer turned songwriter, applied the same assembly line principles to Motown, called after the slang name for Detroit, Motortown.
I had this dream that I wanted a place called Hitsville, because Hitsville, that was a hip little name. Hits and Ville, it was a little factory that made hits. And my dream was that an artist could walk in to one door, just a normal kid off the street, and come out another door, a star. So the machinery, once they got in there. So there were producers, there were writers, there were, you know, the chaperones, the choreographers. Stevie had a lot of people around him. There was a great guy named Clarence Paul who took him under his wing. And Stevie had a teacher, a guy named Ted Hull, who was half blind himself, who really tutored him. Stevie's own mother was in the picture, and she was always there, Lula. So Stevie, being the little guy he was, right away got this sense of stardom.
When Steve was going to do a show, the producers would fly out to the venue and draw out the stage. We knew where the steps were, where the entrances were. They would say, well, Steve, when you walk out here,